How do we know we are having anxiety? We have some anxiety almost every day of our lives. Did you have a test in school today for which you weren't perfectly prepared? And how about that job interview coming up? Even thinking about that might make you nervous. Anxiety is a useful emotion. Without it, we are likely to be heedless and engage in dangerous activities that could lead to harm. It therefore has powerful survival benefits for both we as individuals and our species. However, when levels of anxiety become inappropriately high, they stop being a proportionate response to the threats within the environment and become problematic to the individual experiencing them and can also lead to anxiety disorders. Anxiety is not pleasant, so why do we seem programmed to experience it almost every time we do something important? Surprisingly, anxiety is good for us, at least in moderate amounts. But what happens when these moderate amounts go outside the boundaries? You might actually fail the exam because you can't concentrate on the questions. All you can think about when you're too anxious is how terrible it will be if you fail. You might blow the interview for the same reason. Too much of a good thing can be harmful, and few sensations are more harmful than severe anxiety that is out of control. What makes the situation worse is that severe anxiety usually doesn't go away. Even if we know there is nothing to be afraid of, we remain anxious. Triggers of anxiety. A person suffering from an anxiety disorder is characterized by uncontrollable worry and anxiety about several events or activities. These symptoms are present for at least half the days during a 6 month period. The worry and anxiety among individuals primarily focus on family, finance, work, and illness. In contrast to most people, people with too much anxiety worry even when the things are going well. Moreover, their worries intrude into their awareness when they are trying to focus on other thoughts and they cannot stop worrying. Some other signs, such as the person finds it difficult to control the worry. The anxiety and worry are regularly associated with three or more of the following: restlessness or feeling keyed up or on edge, being easily fatigued, difficulty concentrating or mind going blank, irritability, muscle tension, sleep disturbance. The anxiety, worry, or physical symptoms also cause significant distress or impairment. So next time you start worrying too much or feel restless, it might be symptoms of anxiety. We at Teleminds World advise you to consult a professional when in need. Along with that, we also recommend you to journal your thoughts and be aware of your anxiety triggers. For more videos on mental health awareness and learning, visit us at healthyminds.world and don't forget to share the video and also do subscribe to our channel by clicking on the icon below.